All right, welcome back. So in today's video, I would like to walk you through a little portrait study. And I'm gonna try my best to tell you as much as I can about the process and also the decisions I make along the way. And even more importantly, I will also try to point out what we can take away from it. So someone suggested to me to paint this photo of this young Instagram lady here. And usually this isn't something I would paint. And I also wouldn't recommend someone else to paint it. And that's for various reasons. But then I thought to myself, why not? I mean, I know that I can make this work and turn it into a decent painting, even though the reference material is actually pretty bad. But I also thought that it would make for an interesting video, and one that will give you some insights into the mind of an artist. So here we are. For this painting, I'm using a canvas panel. Nothing special or fancy in any way. As a matter of fact, it's actually one of the cheapest panels that you can get. It's very absorbent and it also has an annoyingly rough surface. But I know how to work my ways around it, and as you will see, at least some of its properties will come in quite handy later in the painting process. I'm using simple flat brushes, but also a few small round brushes. And those are essential for this painting since all the features of the face are really small. As a painting medium, I'm using a lot of safflower oil with a tiny bit of Galkit. And last but not least, I'm using oil paints from various different companies, but mostly Rembrandt, Sennelier and Schminke. So I didn't want to go through the trouble of stretching a canvas. And I also didn't want to cut up my large canvas roll for just one small painting. So I decided to use what I had laying around, and the only thing I had was this tiny cheap canvas panel. It's definitely less than optimal, and actually much too small to paint a face, especially on a canvas this rough. But it's also not the end of the world, and the important thing is that canvas is the right choice here, and the quality of the canvas is only secondary. The painting process for this portrait deviates a little from the way I usually paint, and that's actually how it should be in my opinion. Subject matter, circumstances and materials should always inform and influence the way we paint and how we go about creating a piece of art. In this case, the reference material and also the fact that I'm painting a tiny face on a very rough canvas led me to start the painting by carefully painting one part of the face after another. Painting in such a small scale doesn't really leave any room for errors or corrections. So I have to make sure that I'm as close to the finished look as possible from the get-go. I start by painting the darkest parts of the face, which are the eyes and the mouth, and with those out of the way, and continue to paint the nose. This is probably the most important part of the whole painting, and it will actually make or break it. It's a very particular angle of the nose, and at this small scale, it's incredibly easy to make it look off if one of your brush strokes is off by the tiniest bit. And if the nose looks wrong, the whole face falls apart. So I take my time to render the nose carefully before I move on to the next parts. Now what I'm not going to do here is completely finish an area before I move on to the next, like some artists tend to do these days. And the reason for that is quite simply, you're missing out on a lot of things that happen on a painting surface when paint builds up in layers and light interacts with those layers. But apart from that, painting in one layer also just kinda tends to look bad, and the skin tones look waxy and the proportions tend to look off and on, so we don't want any of that. Next I paint the area around the nose and the eyes, and then I continue to paint the rest of the face. I'm less concerned with accuracy at this point since I will come back to rework everything later in the painting process. I will also repaint and deconstruct areas of the face later in the painting process anyway, so there's really no need to put too much work into these areas at this stage. Usually I paint all of my small scale figure related work on wood panels or similar painting surfaces like the ones I've mentioned in my previous videos. But after seeing the reference photo for this painting, I knew that the only way for me to make this painting work is to paint it on canvas. Painting on canvas is totally different from painting on a wood panel. Not only the finished painting will look dramatically different, but also the painting process will be different. So it's really important to consider this in the conceptual stage of a painting. I don't just grab a canvas panel and start painting. I think about what the finished painting should look and feel like, and also what my reference material looks like. And I let all those details inform my decisions. Of course, that doesn't mean that you can't just start painting on something if you feel like it. But painting for the fun of it and going to the studio and creating art aren't necessarily always the same. The reference material that I'm working with doesn't really have a lot of shadows or contrast. As a matter of fact, the skin doesn't have any contrast at all. It's basically your standard smartphone selfie with pretty bad lighting. The whole face is just made up of soft gradients with slight variations in color. And that's exactly the reason why canvas is the painting surface of choice here. You see, painting gradients, and especially blending subtle color shifts, is very hard on a wood panel. It's actually almost impossible if you aren't experienced and don't have the skills that come with years and years of practice. It's just something that doesn't happen naturally on a hard painting surface. It takes a lot of effort and skill to create certain effects on it. On canvas, on the other hand, this is something that happens naturally. It's actually inevitable. Due to capillary effects and also just the nature of the material, paint will spread and always look somewhat soft. It's easy to create soft edges or to blend colors into one another, and that's what I'm going to use to my advantage here. After very quickly painting the rest of the skin, because I'm very impatient and I can't bring myself to continue to work with the same accuracy, I continue to paint the hair and make some temperature corrections to the skin tones. I consciously leave out the background until I know that I won't be making any major changes to the figure. Instead, I go back to where I started and carefully rework all the areas, starting with the nose and the mouth. I make sure to push the realism a bit more and clean up all the edges. And I do that until I'm more or less happy with the face. After that, I go on to rework the hair, and at this point, I stop painting what I see, and start painting what I know. And the secret to making a painting work lies exactly in that. Just painting what you see will also only get you what you see, and that's in the best case. In most cases, you can't translate something one-to-one anyway, and then you're just left frustrated. At some point in the painting process, you have to free yourself from the reference material and all the biases and expectations that come with it, so that you at least have the chance to be surprised and inspired by the outcome. Next, I lay in the background and start contrasting abstractions with realism, and I go back and forth between destroying parts of the painting and repainting them. And as you can see, sometimes even several times. This process is very intuitive, meaning that I will do these things based on years and years of practice without even thinking about it. And after that, all that's left to do is to make some minor adjustments here and there and clean up some edges. So looking back and considering all the initial parameters, there's much to be said against the success of this painting in particular. I'm working with a bad reference photo here. One that's grainy, it has lens distortion, and it also has horrible lighting. I'm also painting on a far too small painting surface that has a much too rough texture for a portrait this size. But with enough experience, it's not impossible to create a piece of art from suboptimal reference material. And that's really the takeaway here. Creating a piece of art more than anything else depends on the decisions you make along the way. It's less about the quality of the materials and more about choosing the right materials and how you put them to use. It's not unlike making a sandwich. You don't need the freshest tomatoes or a baguette that comes fresh out of a French bakery for that. You just need the basic ingredients. Will it be the greatest sandwich you ever ate? Maybe. Maybe not. Probably not. Who knows? But you know what? With the right ingredients and the right decisions, you can still make a damn good sandwich. But with that being said, guys, we're gonna bring this video to an end. Thanks for watching. Please hit like. Hit subscribe if you're not already a subscriber, and yeah, have a good one.